Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I pray all of you guys are well in the state of Afia. Just a very quick, important and relevant message that I would like to share with you in light of two hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Especially going out for those who think that it's absolutely fine to carry on with their daily routine, to go out, to hang around with the lads and nothing's going to happen and very, very carefree. And even those adults who may be taking the same approach, listen very, very carefully to these two hadith. And listen to them in a way that you take me out of this. So it's like you're listening directly from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying these words to you. And they're very, very relevant to our times and how we need to be behaving and how we need to be carrying ourselves in this with this pandemic going on around the world. And the first of those is a muttafaqun alayhi hadith, which means it's agreed upon hadith. It's both in Bukhari and Muslim. Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala is the narrator. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa baraka wa sallam said, Satakunu fitanun. He said there will appear tribulations. They're going to come about trials. So there's going to be some type of tests that are going to come. And you know, the interesting thing here is the word he uses, fitan, which is the plural of the word fitna. And fitna in Arabic refers to one of three things, either an adab, a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or it refers to a test or a trial, a tribulation, or it refers to a plague or some type of calamity. And no doubt that this fitna that we're experiencing right now in the form of the coronavirus is essentially speaking a fitna in all three meanings. It's a form of punishment for some, it's a form of trial and tribulation for others, and it certainly is a form of calamity for the whole of humanity. So this hadith then is very, very relevant. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that there will appear trials, tribulations. What must we do and what will happen in those trials and tribulations? Listen very carefully. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Al-qa'idu fiha khayrun min al-qa'im. The one who is sitting, when all of these trials and tribulations come, the one who is sitting will be better than the one who is standing. Wal-qa'imu khayrun min al-mashi. And the one who is standing will be better than the one who is walking. Wal-mashi fiha khayrun min al-sa'i. And the one who is walking will be better than the one who is running. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Man tasharrafa laha tastashrifhu, that the one who exposes himself to these trials and tribulations, in other words, he puts himself forward in front of all of these and exposes himself to these trials and tribulations, what will happen? These trials and tribulations will destroy him. And the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam ended with a piece of advice that is very, very, very important. Please take this seriously and listen to this from the core of your hearts and your souls. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "فَمَنْ وَجَدَ مَعَاذًا أَوْ مَلْجَأً فَلْيَعُذْ بِهِ." The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Whoever amidst all of these trials and tribulations finds a refuge or a shelter, then let him take refuge in it." In other words, what he is saying, in the wording that is going around now, stay in your homes. This social distancing that the people are going on about is not something that just the NHS are advising us or something that the government is advising us. 1400 years ago, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us that same piece of advice and the same counsel. Now, despite this, if we're still not going to treat this seriously and if we're still going to be like, oh, well, I'm somehow immune, I'm young, I've got a good immune system and nothing's going to happen and there's no need for us to be observing any of these safety measures and all of this, that's going against the very hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in which he says, do not expose yourself. In other words, don't go out and put yourself at that risk where you are either going to be a carrier of this disease or this illness in this war, or you're going to be somebody who is a risk for others. And the second hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, listen to this as well. Tirmidhi has narrated this and it's been narrated by Sayyidina Uqba bin Amir radiyallahu ta'ala an. He says, قُلْتُ يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ مَنْ نَجَاهُ. He said, I said, O Messenger of Allah, where is salvation? What is salvation? In other words, how can I find myself in safety? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam advised him with three things, and those three things are applicable to our circumstances right now. And what are those three things? He said, the first of those, what you should do is, أَمْسِكْ عَلَيْكَ لِسَانَكَ. Control your tongue. Control your tongue. The second thing that he said is, وَلْيَسَعَكَ بَيْتُكَ. Stay at home. Keep yourself at home. And the third thing that he said was, So the first thing, the third thing that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, wal yasa'aka baytuk, was the second. The first was control your tongue. The second was stay at home. And the third was wabki ala khati'atik, cry over your sins, your wrongdoings. This is very, very much applicable today. This is what we need to be doing. The time that we have in our homes, spend them in a way where we're controlling our tongues. You know, we're very careful what we're saying, especially regarding this pandemic and other things as well, within your own homes as well. You know, it's, when you're together at home, you've got nothing else to do. It's very easy for a person to get into fights with your siblings or your parents and your relatives. Control your tongue, right? Just be very careful and mindful of how you're using your tongue. And the second thing he said, stay at home. Yes, staying at home will be safe. Your safety lies in this. Your salvation lies in this. And the third of those is, if Allah allows us to, Allah gives us this tawfiq, cry over your sins, right? Think back to all of those times that we've done wrong, publicly, privately, where we messed up in life, knowingly, unknowingly, intentionally, unintentionally, whether we have that regret, whether we don't have that regret, cry over that sin. And this is the time to have that regret, because that is where our safety and salvation lies, both in this world and the next. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He allows us to implement the practical dimension of this hadith in a way that's spiritually enriching and empowering for each and every single one of us. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to truly, truly allow us to take heed from all that is going around us, and all of the thousands of deaths and the thousands of people who have been afflicted with this. May Allah grant each and every single one a cure and a swift healing, and protect the rest of us from this illness. We're not, our point is not to go and you know, to make people fearful and panic. No, the simple thing is, do what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us to do 1400 years ago. In that is your safety, your salvation, your security. May Allah perfect this blessing for each and every single one of us. Please share widely with your friends and family, so we can all benefit inshallah from these two hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Jazakumullahu khairan. May Allah keep us in a state of protection. Ameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.